Hello students, today we are going to start our practical course, that is year 213, paper 3 of SOBC Computer Science. So this is a syllabus of our practical course in which we have 10 practicals. Total number of practicals are 10, in which there are two sections. Group A consists 5 practicals and Group B consists 5 practicals. So each section consider same practicals. So among them, the Group A, these are total based on 8051 microcontroller. First is arithmetic, logical and code conversion problem using assembly language or C programming. Second one is interfacing thumbwell and 7 segment display. Third one is traffic light controller using microcontroller. Fourth one is interfacing LCD to microcontroller. Fifth one is waveform generation using DAC, that means digital to analog converter. Then next is event counter using octocoupler using 7 segment display or LCD interfacing. And last one is speed control of stepper motor using microcontroller. So these are the total 7 practical. Among them we have to choose any 5. And Group B consists of these 7 practicals. Similar way, we have to choose any 5 among these 7 practicals. Now we are going to start Group A practicals. These are based on microcontroller. So first thing is that whenever we have to perform the practical based on 8051 microcontroller, we require 3 tools. First is compiler, second one is a programmer, and third one is a hardware part, that is target board and other interfacing devices. So here first we are going to start compiler. The definition of compiler is that compiler is an embedded tool which convert high level language into machine level language. That machine level language is very important for microcontroller because it understood only this language, that is in the form of 0 and 1. So that purpose we have to convert that higher level language like a C into the machine level language. C language is sometimes called as the middle level language. It's user friendly language because it's easy to understand, but machine level language is difficult to understand to human beings. It's only understood by machines, that is a microcontroller or microprocessor-based system. So let's start. This is a KIL compiler. Now I'm telling you the steps how we can create hex file using KIL compiler. This is a KIL. So first select project, then new project, then select specific drive. Now I am choosing here D drive. Create folder, give the names. Right now I am giving the name SY practicals academic year 2020. Okay, again SY practicals. Now open this folder, created folder, and give name. Now we are performing our first practical, that is traffic light control using microcontroller. Traffic light control using microcontroller. So I am giving same name here, traffic light controller using microcontroller, and save this project. Okay, next this window will be open. Select Atmel, click here, then this window will be open. After that we have to choose the specific IC, those IC we are using in our practical. It may be 89C51, 89C52, 89S51, 89S52. Now I am choosing here 89C51. So just select it and OK. Then this is no. After that, here one target is created. The next step is select file, open it and write your program. Now I am pasting here our program, that is a C program, to continuous flashing the LED connected to the port 2, or we can take another program. Okay, here we are performing the practical based on traffic light controller. So this is the interfacing diagram. Here this is 8051 and these are the 4 segments. Each segment consists 3 LEDs in which red, yellow and green. Now we are taking this program. I am here pasting program, but we have to write here proper program. So now this program in assembly language. So that purpose I have to save it using .asm extension. So this is a traffic light control and the extension is .asm. This is very important here, because we have written our program in assembly level language. If our program in C language, so we just put here .c extension. Now we are our program in assembly level language that time, hence we have written your .asm extension and then save it. After that, select this target one, right click on this target one, option for target one, or click here, source group one is open, then right click. Then here add file, so again is for practical, select here all files, so .asm file is available here, so we have to select same file .asm, add here, after that here file is added. Then select that particular file, click right click on this file, build target. After that, here this window is indicating there is a zero error and zero warning, there is a no error. Suppose in case, some error will be occurred. How that error will be occur? Suppose here the specific port is not defined. It's like that. Again, we have to compile it. So there is a error. So whenever I click that error, so it clearly indicate the specific line where error is present. Now, here there is no error. So we are again compile it. Okay, check here. There is a zero error and zero warning. Okay, so this program is okay. Now next option is that click on project, then option for target, for file, then okay, then again click on project, then option for target one, this window will be open, then click here output section, then click here create hex file, then okay, again click on project, then build target, you look here, hex file is created, or you can press F7 for this purpose. Look here, alter F7 and build target, if we just press F7, so automatically hex file will be created if there is no error in a program. So let's check the hex file is created or not in our specific folder. Okay, let's check, minimize it. Then select specific folder. In D drive we have created SY practicals, in which the traffic light controller, and this is object, that means this X file is created here. So now we, in further application, we require this X file. This is very important. The size of X file is also very important. Okay. So in that way, we are using this kill compiler to create hex file. Okay, thank you.